Danganronpa.
Well, hello, 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 everybody. My name is Falcon Ice, and welcome back to Danganronpa. So on the last episode, we left this and a little bit of the heating debate, and let's just get straight to it. Huh? Why not?
ほら、刃物で切りつけられたみたいな傷があるでしょ。いや。刃物って包丁だよね。現場にあった刃物って包丁だけだし。幻想ゲームしてんじゃねえぞ。もっとわかりやすく説明しろや。オッケー。最初に模擬刀の攻撃があったとすると、鞘に包丁の傷があったことの説明がつかないんだよ。
刀を鞘から抜くはずだよね。うん。True。鞘をつけたままなんぞ重くて邪魔なだけだし、威力も半減だろうからな。
いや、どうして鞘に傷が？例えば、いきなり包丁で襲われ、とっさの防御として模擬刀で受けたとしたら、刀を鞘から抜く暇なんてないよね。つまり、
最初に模擬刀が使われたのは包丁の攻撃に対する防御のためだ。オッケー。ということは、先に襲いかかったのは包丁を持った人物だったのですな。分かったぞ。ではこういうことだな。いや、我慢。犯人はあの部屋を訪れた直後、そこに隠してあった包丁を見つけ。Really？包丁でいきなり舞園君に襲いかかったのだ。 I mean, that's kind of possible.
それ彼女はとっさに模擬刀で応戦したが、その模擬刀すらも奪い取られてしまい。そして、模擬刀の一撃で骨折させられた鳩。とどめに包丁で。いいえ、模擬刀で応戦したのは舞園さんだとは考えられないの？いやー。なんで考えられねえんだよ。舞園さんは
模擬刀を手にしていない。それは彼女のからだのある部分を見ればわかるはずよ。That is true. Part of her body that shows that she never used the sword. If you wanted to use a sword, this part of your body would have touched it. If you wanted to use sword, palms.
これだ。それって舞園さんの手のひらだよね。
うん、彼女の手のひらって綺麗なままだったし、模擬刀を手にしたとは思えないよね。どうしてフェノヒラを見ただけでそんなことがわかるの？Because of the coding。あの模擬刀の金箔って、ちょっと触っただけでもすぐ手についちゃうんだよ。実際、模擬刀の柄の部分は塗装がかなり剥がれていたでしょ。うん、きっとあの模擬刀を使った人の手に金箔がついちゃったせいだ。だから、
もし舞園さんが模擬刀を使ってたなら、彼女の手が綺麗なままなのはおかしいんだ。Yep,
true.シャワールームに逃げ込んだ時に洗い流したのかもしれないじゃん。Like, dude, come on. you were about to be killed, and then you still have to wash your hands. You still got the time to do that. Like, come on. Let's get real.
どうして言い切れるの？私がブスだから。
Oh boy. There's no way Sayaka washed the gold coating of her hands because there's a certain regulation that talks about what happens in the bathroom at night time. The water was off.
Monokuma file によると, Maizono-san's死亡時刻は午前1時半頃だったはずだよ.
That's really late, isn't it?
シャワールームの水は出ないはずでしょ。
知らなかったわ。シャワーなんて一度も浴びたことない。ユー。ユー。あんたたち似たようなもんじゃない。ジャンブタニシの匂いがしてるわよ。褒められてるの？なされてるの？あ、です。とにかく、彼女が一度も模擬刀を手にしていないということは、つまり、
So probably Sayaka
grab the knife instead, and the killer grabs the sword and try to kill Sayaka, but Sayaka deflect the sword with the knife, and then I don't know. The one who damaged the sheath would have been the one without the sword. It's the Sayaka. I mean, who else? Yeah, that's my assumption.
だけどさ、確か最初に襲いかかったのって初めに包丁を持った人物が襲いかかり、そのとっさの防御として模擬刀が使われたんだったな。
じゃあ、最初に襲いかかったのもさやか?
ハイソノさん
これで分かったでしょ?
彼女は単なる被害者じゃなかったの。
So maybe she wants to kill this killer?
被害者どころか、まるで自らが殺人を行おうとしていたようだな。
Okay. What?
あいつは厨房から包丁を持ち出し、そして自分が泊まる部屋に犯人を招き入れている。
But then the killer can, retaliate and then, kill Sayaka instead?
さらに、先に包丁で攻撃を仕掛けたのもあいつなのだとすると。確かに。むしろ加害者のような行動だ。
そういえば、苗木くんに部屋の交換を申し出たのは、前園さんの方からでしたわね。もしかすると、彼女が苗木くんに部屋の交換を申し出たのは、苗木くんに自分の罪をなすりつけるためだったのかもしれませんわね。
うん。
お前様さんが、僕に。ですが、そう考えれば、 ネームプレートの件もしっくりきますわ。彼女は標的にした人物を自分が泊まる苗木くんの部屋に呼び寄せたかった。その部屋で殺人を犯すことによって疑惑を苗木くんに向けようとしたのです。ですが、そのためには部屋の交換を伏せたまま標的を呼び出さなければならなかった。
標的に部屋の交換がバレてしまえば、間違いなく怪しまれてしまいますからね。そのためにネームプレートを交換したって。ですが、その計画は危険すぎやしませんかね。たとえ標的を殺すことに成功しても、その後苗木誠殿が部屋の交換をバラしてしまったら。それはどうかな。
お人よしの苗木に前園を切り捨てるような真似ができたとは思えんが。オッケー。前園もそう思っていたからこそ部屋の交換相手に苗木を選んだんじゃないのか。それに彼女は超高校級のアイドルよ。冴えない苗木と国民的アイドルの前園の主張、普通ならどちらの主張を信じるかしら。
では、
彼女はそのことも計算に入れて。マジかよ。ですが、そんな彼女の計画も失敗に終わった。いや、she gets killed instead。包丁で襲いかかった際、彼女は模擬刀の反撃を受けてしまい、そこで右手首を骨折し、包丁を落としてしまったのでしょう。そして、
標的であったはずの人物によって逆に殺されてしまった。ちょっと待ってよ、そんな遅いよ。いやー、kind
of makes sense now.
だってさ。
What?
ねえねえ、なんだか議論が脱線してない?
は? Huh?
そんなセピア色のお話なんかよりもさ、ほら、早く黒を決めちゃわないと。
Despair.
そうだべ。まずは犯人を決めねえと。
ナイヒコ、今は謎の解明に集中して。
Why is everything is on Naegi? Is it really all over? Obviously, I'm committed to finding out who killed her, but what can I do? I mean, as far as clues go, there's nothing left. Well, there is the trash can, the trash room. Dying message. I mean this one, right? There's still another clue. Oh, come on now.
Dying message.
It's very obvious it's Leon. Okay, that as well. But I don't know. Maybe the killer used Sayaka's finger to wrote it. That's possible as well. Or maybe it's just Sayaka. There's no question that Sayaka wrote that message, and I can't prove it. Left index finger. I mean, if you only throw some numbers, then how do this computer genius understand the concept of it? It's pretty much just a number. It's Leon. Damn it, it's no use. I just don't know. There we go, finally. Huh? Rotate it? I think maybe I see something. I'm not sure it's the killer. Leon is the killer. I don't know. Sayaka's text message revealed the real killer's name. If you turn the message 180 degrees, it should become crystal clear. Select someone. I mean, based on the numbers he wrote, and yeah, it's him. it's really easy from the beginning.
たまたま、そう見えただけだって。偶然の産物だっつーの。
Nope, it's clear it's your name. Yep.
彼女は壁にもたれかかった体勢で背後の壁にメッセージを書いた。おそらく手だけを背中の後ろに回した後ろ手の状態でメッセージを書いたんでしょう。その体勢で書いてしまったせいで正面から見ると 180度ひっくり返った形になってしまったの。実際に自分で試してみるといいわ。その状態で書くと字が反転してしまうはずだから。んなの、ただの口づけじゃねえか。俺が犯人だ。てめえそんなこと言うんじゃねえって。あなたが犯人じゃないなら、どうしてあなたが証拠を処分しようとしたの。
内木君、あなただって知っているはずよ。桑田君が処分しようとした証拠のこと。
Maybe the cuff? The evidence that Leon tried to get rid of. Is that the thing I found on the ground in front of the incinerator, right? So either this or this. But I'm probably go with this one. Let's see. Yep, it is.
それって焼却炉の前に落ちた Y シャツの燃えかすのことだよね。おそらく犯人はマイザノさんを刺し殺した際に返り血を浴びたんでしょう。その返り血を浴びた Y シャツを処分するためにそれを焼却炉に放り込んだの。その際に燃えかすを残してしまったのですね。きっと犯人も気づいていなかったはずよ。気づいていたら
Yeah, probably the killer is really panicked at that moment.
そうだね。なんだ。なんか、そのワイシャツだけで桑田レオンを犯人だと断定できるのか。袖口が白いワイシャツを着てる人は桑田くん以外にもたくさんいるもんね。そうだ。ワイシャツを着てるやつなんて
俺以外にもいるんだ。そんな燃えかすだけじゃ誰の門かなんて分かるはずねえだろ。いや、証拠品自体から割り出せなくても他の点から割り出すことができるかもしれない。どうやら見えてきたみたいね。全ての謎の答え。なんとなくだけど。The
burnt remains of the button-up shirt which the killer was unable to get rid of. There's something about it we need to pay attention to in order to figure out who's responsible. What? Maybe where it was disposed of? Because of how- yeah, let's go with this. Oh no, wrong. And then killer will become clear. And it was destroying but okay. Yeah. When or how? Let's go with how. Okay, there it is. Oh boy.
そうか。なるほど。俺には分かったぞ。ん?トラッシュルームの鉄格子を開けなきゃ焼却炉には近づけねえし。ああ、おや。あの焼却炉のスイッチも押せねえはずだよな。うん。そんで、そのトラッシュルームの鍵は掃除当番が持ってんだったよな。There
it is.
つまり犯人は掃除当番ってことになるよな。
No, that's wrong. There was another way to use the incinerator without being the one on cleaning duty. And that's exactly what proves that Leon is the real killer. Okay. Using the crystal ball. Let's see. That's true. You'd have to. Oh wait, no. That's the. Okay. My bad. Okay, so the third option then. Boom. Alright, break!
ちょっと待って。掃除当番じゃなくても消光処分する方法はあったはずよ。だが、結合紙を開けなければ焼却炉の火をつけることはできんのだぞ。いや、それが可能だったんだよ。これを使えばね。うん?割れちまってるけど、ガラス玉みてえだな。But
seriously, this killer has a really great accuracy.
いや、水晶玉のはずだったんだけども。これを使うってどうやって使うの?
The killer had to use the glass ball in a certain way, which was throw it, roll it, divine with it.
犯人は鉄格子の隙間からこのガラス玉を投げたんだ。焼却炉のスイッチめがけてね。
Someone turned the incinerator on? Very strange. I'm quite certain it was off last time I was down here. Perhaps it was the work of a fairy.
鍵を持っていて山田君も知らないうちに焼却炉の火がついてたわ。犯人は鉄格子を開けずに焼却炉のスイッチを押したからだったんだ。そうやって焼却炉の火をつけたところで、そこに丸めたワイシャツを投げ込んだのよ。
Well, I mean, even Leon background, he's the number one baseball player, so it's pretty obvious that he can throw.
おい、何言ってんだよ。犯人が鉄格子の中に入っていないことは、証拠隠滅後の状況が物語っているわ。割れたガラス玉、つけっぱなしの焼却炉の火、燃えかすが残ってしまったという雑な処分方法。掃除当番の犯人なら、 もっと丁寧に証拠を隠滅しているはずよ。いや、ちょっと待てって。でもさ、鉄格子から焼却炉までって10メートル以上は離れてたよね。そんな距離からガラス玉を投げてピンポイントでスイッチに当てるなんて、そんなこと本当にできるのかな?
Yeah, if you're a pitcher and on a baseball player.
そうだ。
It wouldn't have been much of a challenge at all for the killer because ultimate baseball star.
バカ言ってんじゃん。ねって。
確かに、超高校級の野球選手と称される彼なら 10メートル先の的など大したことないでしょうね。
ふざけんな! 俺は犯人なんかじゃねえっつーの! つーか今の推理だって全然間違ってんだよ!
クソボケうんこたれ! If you want to say that you're not wrong, to throw some argument that block all this. What did you call it? that's it.
だって、ナイギ君、もう一度事件を振り返り、彼の犯行のすべてを明らかにするのよ。それで終わりにさせましょう。
Okay.
りだってんだよ。
桑田君、君が何と言おうと全ての謎はもう解けてるんだ。今回の事件の答えはこれだ。
The closing argument is about to begin. Would you like to hear more? Yep. Ooh, okay. Venus Act 1. Wait. So, this is the first one. And then, comes the door and try to kill, and nope. Not gonna happen, then this one happen. And then... what is it? I think this... Right? Wait. No. This one first. Sayaka is attacking, then this block, and then... counter attack, and then this happened, and then it goes to the bathroom, locked inside, and then try to open it because he thought it's locked, and then kill. Wait a second, this is kind of confusing. Wait. Where the... Whoa, no. It should be this one. Right? Wait. This is a little bit confusing. So yeah, this is right, and then slap, and then saw the sword, and then blocks, and then hit the wrist. Okay. Oh my god. I'm not sure. So, and then it's this one. Yep. Then got out, and then use the lint roller. And then obviously this one. Okay. And then it's this one. And the last one is what? Probably this. Wait, is this the right way? Hold on, I'm still not sure about this too. Yeah, this one. But I think it's right because Sayaka tried to kill and then he blocks it, and then bam, knife dropped, and then. It's not the sword to kill, it's pick up the knife. Yeah, okay. Let's do this. Creak!
Badum. おそらく前園さんはその人物を殺すつもりで部屋に呼んだんだよ。そして彼女はあらかじめ用意していた厨房の包丁でその人物に襲いかかったんだ。
ミス。Okay, that's right.
そこで予期せぬ事態が起きた。その人物が僕の部屋に置いてあった模擬刀で反撃してきたんだ。その攻防の末、模擬刀の攻撃によって前園さんは右手首を骨折してしまって、
おう、グレート。 OK then, so it's this one. Alright. So I guess that's it. Alright.
その攻防のせい、小木刀の攻撃によって前園さんは右手首を骨折してしまって。There it is。そこで包丁を奪われてしまったんだ。追い詰められた前園さんは慌ててシャワールームに逃げ込んだ。犯人はすぐに後を追ったけど、なぜかシャワールームのドアは開かなかった。
But how does this guy get the screwdriver? Since on the Makoto's room, Makoto's tool still unsealed, still on condition sealed. Whatever.
それでも犯人をなんとかドアをこじ開け、そして奪った包丁で前園さんを刺したんだ。だけど前園さんは残った力でその場にダイイングメッセージを残した。犯人に気づかれないように自分の背中側の壁にね。 そこで彼女は力尽きてしまったんだ。前園さんを殺した後、犯人は慌てて証拠隠滅に取り掛かった。まず返り血のついたシャツを脱ぎ、そして僕の部屋にあったクリーナーで部屋中を徹底的に掃除した。 自分が部屋を訪れたという痕跡を消すためにね。その後犯人は脱いだワイシャツを処分するためにトラッシュルームへと向かった。そこにある焼却炉で帰り地についたワイシャツを燃やそうとしたんだ。だけどトラッシュルームは鉄格子で封鎖されてて焼却炉に近づくことができなかった。 そこで犯人が使ったのは、ハガクレ君がランドリーに置き忘れていたガラス玉だったんだ。鉄格子の隙間からガラス玉を投げることで焼却炉のスイッチを入れたんだ。普通の人なら不可能に近い発想だけど、犯人にはそれを可能にする自信があった。Use
the baseball star, so
超高校級の野球選手だったからなんだ。Yep. 正確なコントロールで投げられたガラス玉は焼却炉のスイッチに当たり、そして焼却炉は稼働を始めた。こうして証拠を隠滅した犯人を安心し、すぐにトラッシュルームを後にした。だけどそこには誤算があったんだ。
But wait, there's something more.
だけど、そこには誤算があったんだ。バブーン。そうだね。クワタレオン君。Complete。あのガラス玉は。 ハガクレ君がランドリーに忘れたものらしいけど、桑田君はシャツの血を洗い流そうと向かったランドリーでそれを見つけたんじゃないの。そしてその時、今の方法を思いついた。どうなの桑田君、何か反論がある？
Yeah, it's pretty much it.
反論があるからって。あるよ、あるに決まったんだろうが。
Give me the reason.
今のって全部推論だろ。証拠がねえじゃねえか、証拠がいや。
Ah, come on. We already said everything about the evidence.
証拠がなけりゃただのでっち上げだ。そんなもん認めねえぞ。
内木君、だったら教えてあげるといいわ。 彼が犯人だという証拠をね。あなたはその証拠を持っているはずよ。
Why don't you just say it, Kyoko? I mean, come on. I have the evidence. The first bullet time battle is about to begin. Would you like to hear more? Yep.
犯人はシャワールームのドアノブからネジを外す際、その部屋にあったものを使わなかった。その代わりに彼が使ったのは、おそらく彼自身のものだったはずよ。
Yeah.They used something of their own to remove the screws. Could it have been... Yeah, he's... With you saying that, then he's pretty much you give away all the things now. Yeah, whatever. You did it. Okay then, I have to show indisputable evidence that Leon is the killer. I need to figure it out. Alright, here it is.The moment of truth. Wait. How? There it is. Come on. This is hard, man.This is so hard. Oh my god. What am I doing? Okay, I get the hang of it. Come on. There it is.Oh my god. What is this? It's so hard. Nobody believes me. Nobody wants to hear what I have to say.
We are here with the end of the debate. Well then, the class has officially adjourned. Now it's time to reveal who's the placket.
It would be that one of the most focused Makoto. Ooh, wow.However, Makoto is not a placket.
Too bad. Looks like the real killer gets to graduate. Congratulations to them. On the other hand, everyone else must now be punished.
Why I can't do that? What do you say? Wanna give another shot? Well, yeah. Nope. I'm okay. Yeah, let's just skip that.I cannot aim. What should I do? See? There it is. Okay. There it is.Okay, there it is. There it is. There it is. Oh, come on! There it is. Boom! Finally! I wonder what's happening with the aim.There's no rectangle or something as well.
シャワールームのドアノブはネジが外されてたけどさ。犯人はそのネジを外す際、どんな道具を使ったんだろうね。
ネジを外すって言ったら、
どう
だったら配られた工具セットの中にあったべ。
あれを使ったんでしょうな。他に工具などありませんでしたし。
だけど僕の部屋にあった工具セットには。使われた形跡なんてなかったんだ。
Yep.
犯人は現場を苗木くんの部屋ではなく舞園くんの部屋だと思い込んでいたはずだからな。
Because Sayaka left the notes inside Leon's room and then he brings his own toolkit because he thought that it's Sayaka's room instead of Nike. Okay, now that makes sense because Maybe he knows that the bathroom of the girl's room is... It can be locked.
Alright.
Mm-hmm. He's using himself. Yeah, it's you. Yep.
もし僕の考えが合っているなら、その工具セットのドライバーには使用された痕跡が残っているはずなんだ。もし別の用途で使ったというなら、どこでどんな使い方をしたのか説明してもらおう。
Oh, there we go.
先に言っておくけど、 なくしたなんて言い訳はなしよ。
Dang. Well, there it is. There's no turning back. Yep. There's no helping now. There's no helping you. Then my 10-1 is C, like, oh. Oh boy, I mean, I don't know, it's just kind of weird. Okay, thank you. Not from concentrate. Okay, I'll take that achievement.
お手元のスイッチで投票してくださいあ、念のために言っとくけど必ず誰かに投票するようにしてくださいねこんなつまらないことで罰を受けたくないでしょ。Make
triple sure.
はい、では張り切ってまいりますよ。
You are the only one who gets excited about this one.
投票の結果、黒となるのは誰か。 その答えは正解なのか不正解なのか。
Oh. Alright. Monokuma vote. There you have it.
Looks like you got it right on the money. The blacken in this case, the one that killed Sayaka, was none other than Leon Kuwada.
Leon? Leon, did you really kill Sayaka? What the hell is wrong with you? It was kill or be killed. So that's why I killed her first. None of you are any different. One wrong step and you'd be the one standing here. It was complete chance that I wound up like this. I was just unlucky. That's all. Hey, come on, you expect me to just accept my death? I mean, there's no helping you now. Everything's become clear. The decision we made was right after all. But when I think about that, honestly, I'd be better off we'd been wrong. Because if what we came up with really is the truth, then that truth is that Sayaka was trying to frame me. Yeah. It's still, but even if that's true, I cannot say she was wrong. After all, the mastermind, it's all because of that video. Even I couldn't handle what I saw in there. If I was her and the video actually had something to do with me, I couldn't even imagine. Now we're trapped here with no way out. They're probably waiting for me. I cannot afford to be stuck in here. The one thing that was more important to her than anything else, her dreams, her friends. They have to see something like that happen to them. I mean, every single one of them, every single one of the students have this kind of video as well. And Sayaka. I did whatever it took to reach that dream. I mean it. Even some things that weren't so pleasant. And that's why Sayaka, for the friends that meant so much to her, that's why she betrayed me. So when she said, because you want to blame Naegi. Yeah, right. She was lying to me from the very beginning. She was using me. Yep. Is that why she talked to me in the first place? I guess I'll never know. Because there's nothing I can do to ask her what she was thinking. When she was dead, that's that. Boy, howdy! The entertainment industry must sure be terrifying, huh? I mean, to try and kill someone just because of those relationships. She seems so nice and lovely on the outside, but inside, she descended into pure madness. What did you say? I understand, really I do. Yep. You're in utter despair thanks to Sayaka's betrayal, right? Compassion, intimacy, love. The stronger those feelings, the stronger the despair when they collapse. Stop screwing with us! This is all your fault. Sayaka being forced to do something like that. All of it, everything. It's all your fault! Suddenly in a frenzy, I lunged at Monokuma. But... there it is. As angry as I was, Kyoko latched onto my arm without hesitation. Her grip was like iron, strong enough I was sure it would leave a bruise. If you really want to make her enemies pay for what they've done, you need to let it go for now. Damn it!
Okie dokie.
Ah, that was a close one. I thought for sure you were gonna give me a good walloping. Just barely avoided punishment, you did. Now then, since you so magnificently revealed the identity of the killer during the class trial, the blackened Leon Kuwata will receive his punishment. Okay, I don't know what will the execution will. Because, remember Junko execution? I mean punishment is just... I don't know about this one. I didn't have a choice. I had to kill her. Yeah, that's it. I was just protecting myself in the heat of the moment. It was self-defense. Oh, exactly. Was it self-defense? When you forced your way into the bathroom, did you or did you not use your very own toolkit? After Sid shut herself in the bathroom, you went out of your way to head back to your room, our room. Then you came all the way back, broke into the bathroom, and killed her. Am I wrong? You had any number of chances to stop what you were doing, but you choose not to. Is it not because you had an unclouded intent to commit murder? Sela's got a point there. No, that's not... Stop it. I've had enough of this. Oh, are you sure? You were closer to her than anyone, were you not? He killed your precious Sayaka. Do you understand? I cannot say Leon is solely to blame. Of course, I don't plan on blaming Sayaka either. Because the one to blame is him! Huh? If it weren't for you, this never would have happened. Or to Sayaka. Or Leon. We shouldn't be fighting each other. We should be fighting against the one who put us in this situation. The mastermind. Uh-oh, do you awaken to your sense of justice?
Well, it just so happens that there's nothing more unethical than an unwavering sense of justice. After all, it's people with that sort of mentality that perpetuate war all over the world. Is that the kind of justice that's awakened within you? Just shut up! Okay, well, anyway, more importantly, let's hurry up and get to what everyone's been waiting for. The punishment!
Begging you, please don't do this!
No more begging, no more excuses. You must pay the penalty for breaking the rules. Society demands it.
Okay. So probably he getting hit with the baseball bat till death or something. Okay. Okay. Boop. Game over. Leon was been found killed. Time for the punishment. Oh boy. Okay, he's being strangled. Yeah, in a baseball stadium. Dang. Is that a machine gun? It's a baseball. Getting shot with the baseball until death. How fitting. 100,000 blow. Jesus Christ. And all his friend is watching him. My god, that's kind of ruthless. Can you imagine being hit by one ball only on your head? It's really hurt already, but 1,000 with a machine that shoots a really fast ball like that? Gosh. My goodness. Oh boy. What we saw, that was the true face of despair. I mean, if you cannot call it that, what else could we call it?
Extreme.
Ah, boy. Man, my adrenaline is pumping right out of control. Do we really have to keep doing this? I just cannot take it.
Yeah.
Well, hey, if you don't like it, all you gotta do is swear to cut all ties with the outside world and accept living here forever. But that's only if every single one of you can get on board with that. Despair. Man, bleep you! Why the bleep are you doing all this evil bleep to us?
Nandayo!
Evil? You make it sound like I'm some dark, awful secret society type of guy.
Anya.
Or in that case, a dark, awful secret society type of bear! So why are you putting an upstanding young citizen like me through such a grueling ordeal? It seems like you're trying to use common sense to make sense of something that doesn't make sense. There's a lot of sense in this dialogue. That's like trying to put a mile on a scale. I just don't think it's possible. I don't think what you're saying and what I'm saying quite fit together.
You piece of bleep! I don't know who you are, but I'm gonna pound your ass till to the ground.
You must really hate me to get so angry, huh? But if you do that, you're barking way up the wrong tree. What happened? Happened because more than one of you decided you wanted to get out, right? No matter how much time passes, you cannot cut free of your regrets from the outside world. You're to blame.
Of course we cannot get free of the outside world, be trapped in this same place.
You're trapped, are you? Well, I'm sure once you learn all the mysteries of this school, your thinking will change for sure. You'll think, boy, isn't it so wonderful how we all get to live here forever?
Not really. What are you trying to say?
I feel like there's some deeper meaning hidden in there, just like before. Anyway, let's get to the blackened punishment. That's what everyone is waiting for, after all.
When you say everyone, who exactly are you referring to?
Sorry, I said everything I've got to say.
Oh.
I need to save some of the fun for later.
Okay, and just like that, he was gone. He left us there, overwhelmed by a nightmare turned reality.
Okay. Let's just take a deep breath for once for now.
Okay, let's continue. Even after he was gone, we stood there forever, unable to move. Actually, no, it wasn't that long, I think. Everyone just lost their sense of time. We were all too scared. Scared of being alone. No one even tried to speak. Their faces were stone, their voices dead. But it was at that moment. Kyoko.
This Kyoko, there's something about her.
Makoto, can I talk to you for a second? She moved in close and whispered into my ears.
Naegi-kun.
Before we head back, there's something I want to talk to you about. Huh? It's about Sayaka, isn't it? Okay, I'm surprised you figured it out.
Ne?
I told you before the class trial started. You had to figure out the mystery of this case yourself. You wanted me to realize how Sayaka betrayed me by myself, didn't you? The thought never even crossed my mind. I feel like such a fool, becoming such an easy target like that.
So ne.
Sayaka meant to double cross you. That's a fact. That you can never change. But even till the very end, she wasn't sure of her decision. That's why. As she lay dying, she was thinking of you.
Really?
How do you know? She was thinking of me? You're gonna just say something like that? I mean, there's no way you can know that.
Yep, true.
Only Sayaka would know for sure, and we cannot ask her now.
だけど...
Even you, if you cannot ask her, you can infer it, don't you think? Her final thought was how she could protect you. What?
それは...
The fact that she used her last ounce of energy to leave her dying message proves it.
Okay.
If she didn't care what happened to you, she never would have left that message. Well, maybe she just wanted to get back at the person who had killed her.
確かに.
That's certainly one possibility, but I don't think that's what it was.
とにかく.
She was uncertain. She wasn't sure she could kill someone or deceive you. Which is why her plan failed. Her hesitation attracted failure.
So.
It's almost ironic when you think about it. Why are you telling me all this? Because you're the kind of person who can overcome this. Because you can move past the deaths of your friends, Sayaka and Leon, and keep moving forward.
Ooh! She didn't mention Junko in this. Ooh! Ooh! Junko! Ooh!
So.
Without someone like that, the others would never be able to break free of such a desperate situation. Move past their deaths? That's...
I could never do that. No, I'm going to carry them with me the rest of my life. How could I possibly move past something like that? Leon, Sayaka, I'll carry them with me forever. I'll carry their memories with me wherever I go. Again, nobody mentioned Junko. So instead of forgetting them, you're choosing the hard road. Well, I have high expectation for you. As he said that, she revealed that small smile.
Ah, there it is. There it is, the kudere. Just show us some that precious smile of her.
Ne.
By the way, I have to admit, I'm curious. How did you know I wanted to talk to you about Sayaka? Oh, well... I'm...
Oh no! Oh, the callback! Oh!
I'm psychic. Kidding, I just have pretty good intuition.
Oh no! Oh! The callback! Oh!
Dang, only chapter 1 and we already lost 3 people? Oh boy. Got an item! Despair bat. What is the loneliest number? Okay. Let's save over here.
Oh no! I didn't expect that! Oh boy!
Okay, so we're back inside the room. This is this Sayaka's room or is it my room? Or maybe Leon? I don't know, but yeah, I'll just leave this episode one here. Oh my gosh. I'm really drained out already because of this trial. First, this is even not first trial. I have no idea what will happen in the next trial. Like, dude. Oh boy, this game, but it's really amazing though. Yeah, I'll just leave this episode. I cannot even speak right now. I'm sorry, okay. Let me gather my thoughts for now. Okay. Well, I guess I'll just leave this episode here for now. And, yeah. It's just crazy. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you for coming. Thank you for everyone together with me. Spread the love, spread the fun. And I'll see you guys in the next video. See ya!